Hi, welcome back to CBSC Board Economics. I'm Saddam Hussein here. I welcome you all. Last class, we discussed about opportunity cost. What exactly is opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative foregone. Choose the best alternative and you leave the second best alternative. That's opportunity cost. We discussed with an illustration, an example, that is, if a farmer has a piece of land on which he can grow either rice or he can grow wheat. He can't grow both of them. If the farmer is getting 1,000 rupees from rice and getting 1,500 from wheat, obviously the farmer will go in for wheat. So to gain something, you have to lose something. So the opportunity cost of wheat is rice worth 1,000 rupees. That's opportunity cost. To put it in one line, opportunity cost is the cost of the next best alternative foregone. Now today we'll learn one more new concept. What exactly is marginal opportunity cost, MOC, or marginal rate of transformation, MOC or MRT? What is the difference between opportunity cost and MRT, marginal rate of transformation? What is the difference between opportunity cost and marginal opportunity cost? Marginal opportunity cost is defined as the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. MOC is defined as the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. What does it mean? In case of opportunity cost, you just had to rice and wheat. You chose rice, you had to leave wheat. If you choose wheat, then you had to leave wheat, rice. There are only two things. But in case of marginal opportunity cost, MOC or MRT, this is the rate of change. When you go on choosing one for the other, so at what rate you sacrifice the other commodity? It is the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. Look at the graph here, the table, you'll understand better. So look at this table, I'm off the board. Marginal opportunity cost, MOC or MRT, this is PP schedule, production possibility schedule. In this case, we assume the economy is producing only two commodities, guns and butter. In A possibility, look at this carefully, in production possibilities, the economy is producing zero guns and 10, maybe tons of butter. That means the economy is producing only butter and no guns. This is an extreme possibility we discussed. B possibility, the economy has increased the production of guns maybe by one and the economy has to sacrifice butter. Why the economy has to sacrifice? Because of limited resources or scarcity of resources. In this case, you see in the fourth column, marginal opportunity cost, MRT, to produce one gun, the economy sacrificed one butter. So we wrote it here, 1y is 1x. So how do you, what is the formula for marginal opportunity cost or marginal rate of transformation, MOC or MRT, delta y upon delta x? That is the number of units of y good you are sacrificing, that's butter in this case, to gain one more of x commodity, in this case guns. Okay, we further move from B to C. When we move from B to C, you produce one more gun. To produce one more gun, or you sacrifice 2 butter, 2y. So it has come down from 10 to 9, 9 to 7. That means you give up 2y to get 1x. That means 2 butter to get 1x. And again from C possibility, we move to D possibility. When you move here, you produce one more gun. How much butter you sacrificed here? Maybe 3 units of butter, 7 to 4, 3y is 1x. When we move from D to E possibility, you sacrificed 4 butter to get one more gun. So what is happening here? MOC, marginal opportunity cost, the rate of sacrifice is increasing. 1, 2, 3, 4. So marginal opportunity cost, it clearly shows the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. So rate of sacrifice here, we discussed in the last video. So why the rate of sacrifice? Why not 1:1, 1:1? Why not 1y:1x and again 1y:1x here? We discussed it. Why the MOC, marginal opportunity cost, or MRT is increasing? It is increasing because all the resources are not equally efficient to produce all the commodities. If you divert the resources from one use to the other use, they become marginally less and less efficient. So you must have read it that all the resources have specificity. That means an economics teacher is capable of teaching economics. He can't teach maths. Even if he's teaching maths, it takes more time. He has to sacrifice more number of economics hours in order to teach one more hour of maths. Same way, physics teacher won't be able to teach you economics. So in order to teach more number of economics hours, the physics teacher has to sacrifice more hours of physics. So that is a clear case. All resources are not equally efficient. If you divert the resources from one use to the other use, they become marginally less and less efficient. Their efficiency will come down, hence the cost of production will go up. It's a simple one more example we can understand. Normally, the soldiers are trained to fight in the warfare. If you send the soldiers to fight in the war, more and more farmers will die. I repeat again, the soldiers are trained to fight in the war. If you send farmers instead of soldiers, more and more farmers will die. So 1, 2, 3, 4 farmers are dying here because they are not so efficient like soldiers. So now here, marginal opportunity cost. So what you have seen, opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is the rate of, no, not opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is defined as the cost of the next best alternative foregone. To produce wheat, you sacrifice rice. That's opportunity cost. You have to choose one. What is marginal opportunity cost? It is the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. Rate of sacrifice. At what rate you are sacrificing good Y in order to produce good X? So in this case, the rate of sacrifice is increasing. First, you gave up 1y in order to produce 1x. Then you gave up 2y, gave up 3y, 4y to produce one more unit of x. It's a clear case. Why are you giving up? Because all the resources are not equally efficient. If you divert the resources from one use to the other use, they become marginally less and less efficient. Hence, the cost of production will go up. That's why it's called marginal opportunity cost. Or marginal rate of transformation. Marginal rate of transformation means when you transform one commodity in terms of the other commodity, the rate of transformation will go up, or the cost of production will go up. That's why it's called marginal opportunity cost. I repeat once again, just in one sentence, opportunity cost is defined as the cost of the next best alternative foregone. To produce wheat, we have to sacrifice rice. That's opportunity cost. MOC is defined as the rate, again I repeat, it's the rate of sacrifice of one commodity in order to produce one more unit of the other commodity. The formula for MOC is delta Y upon delta X. It keeps on increasing MOC, remember, because of increasing MOC, the shape of the PPC is concave to the origin. Because of this 1, 2, 3, 4, the shape of the PPC is concave to the origin, the production possibility. The slope of the PPC is nothing but MOC or MRT. It's concave to the origin. That's all we have time for this video. Till we meet next time, it's goodbye from Saddam Hussein. Don't forget to share, subscribe, like, and comment on our videos. Please press the bell icon to get the future videos, which are quite informative and helpful for examinations. Thank you guys. Bye-bye.